It comes at a turbulent time for Egypt. The country's presidential runoff happens later this month on June 16th and 17th. I'm joined now by Egyptian journalist Mona Eltahawy in New York. Mona, on a grander sense, the big picture, what does this verdict mean for Egypt?
Well, the verdict overall, Rob, is seen by many people in Egypt as the latest blow of injustice, basically, from the military junta that has been ruling Egypt since the revolution forced Mubarak to step down on February the 11th. A lot of people feel that there was lots of forgery during the election, that we have the runoff coming up on the 16th and the 17th, as you said, and they're very dissatisfied with the two contenders. One is considered a part of the old regime, Ahmed Shafi, and one is from the Muslim Brotherhood, Mohamed Morsi. And people are putting this verdict in the middle of this whole big bag and saying this is just a big charade by the military junta, and that despite the life sentence that Mubarak got, the fact that his sons were acquitted and all of those interior ministry officials were acquitted, and on top of that, not a single police officer over the past 15 months has been found guilty of killing the almost 1,000 people who've died during the revolution. All of that has caused a tremendous amount of anger that you saw explode in the courtroom. And the people weren't just chanting, "The people demand the fall of the regime." They're also very importantly chanting, "The people demand the cleansing of the judiciary," because this is all considered part of a very, very corrupt regime that remains very much in place.
So where do we go here? I mean, at the very beginning there, you made the point that the two presidential runoff candidates are pretty much from the old regime. So what are citizens of Egypt saying about that? They must be furious and frustrated.
Well, they are. One is from the old regime. He was Mubarak's prime minister, last prime minister. And one is from the Muslim Brotherhood, who's one of the longest opposition parties in the country. And one of them only got 25% and one got 24%. So that just shows you how few votes each of them got. And now the country has to choose between the two, which is why, you know, I stress that people feel a lot of anger in Egypt and they feel really cornered by a military junta that they see determined to hold on to the reins of power. I've always said that we replace one Hosni Mubarak with 19 Hosni Mubaraks, and they're the generals who form the Supreme Council of the Armed Forces. And people see them as very much manipulating everything on the scene in Egypt, and that's what's driving the anger. I'm hearing from some social media reports that police are trying to close the roads leading into Tahrir Square. I don't know if this is confirmed or not, but this is by way of showing you that people want to go on the street and demonstrate against what they consider a great injustice.
Mona Eltahawy, thanks for that great insight.